chains falling. I hear those chains falling.
Break every chain, break every chain. What? We are breaking with chain. How can you be breaking chain over born again believers? Which chain are we breaking? You are in Christ. Where are the chains? That is a deceived audience in their song. They are led astray in their song. So this deception by humans, by wrong teachers, by prophets, has a way of manifesting itself in conduct, in prayer, in praise worship, and in the way you relate with the so-called God that is a figment of your imagination. I'm teaching here. Please, if you're following, shout, I hear you. Yeah. And then when people tell you that everything natural is determined by spiritual, then at the same time they will tell you that God lives in them. God lives in me. So that means both God and me, it is the spiritual that controls us. Am I communicating? If you're getting the point, say, I hear you. Yeah. I don't like sound bites. You know, people just catch one cliche and throw. I don't like sound bites. Before you take a statement, you've got to find out how it is valid in doctrine. Don't just carry things that sound nice. You know, I heard of a man of God who was preaching and saying, you know, I am blessed with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. He said, all my blessings are in heavenly places. Then he says, and you know, the Bible tells us that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual forces in heavenly places. Then he said, both your blessings and your enemies are in heavenly places. And people said, whoa, what a big revelation. It's not a big revelation. It's nonsense, because that word places is not in the original. So he's building a doctrine out of an addition that was put in the Bible by the translator's advantage. I don't know if I'm communicating here. He didn't see that places is in italics. There's nothing like heavenly places. Heavenly places. How many places are the heavenlies? Okay, Jesus is seated in the heavenly places. That means he has many buttocks. His bum bum is in different places in heaven. So Jesus has more than one bum. Can't you see that something is wrong with that addition? There's nothing like places. It is supposed to be in the heavenlies. I'm teaching here. Yeah, see. That's why the scriptures must be rightly divided. There is something more powerful than God. And I'm going to show you. There's something more powerful than God. If there is nothing more powerful than God, why will God desire that every man be saved? Why will he desire it? Why doesn't he get everybody saved? Why doesn't he call everybody saved? Why does he desire? How can an all-powerful God be desiring something? I thought he is all-powerful. He should collect it. Think about that. We'll get a bit more into it. And there is something that is more powerful than the word of God. There is something more powerful than the word of God. You have made the word of God of none effect by what? So tradition can neutralize the word. Think about it. We'll get into all of that. So when you find some people, no matter how much they are hearing the word of God in the church, nothing is changing in their life, know that they have employed something that neutralizes the word. As the word is coming, they are neutralizing it. It's not that the word is not powerful. The word is powerful. That's why some people are getting results and there are some people no result, because there's something in their life constantly neutralizing the word. The word is coming in full power, but they are quenchers. Praise God. I'm teaching here. Thank you, Lord. Look at 1 John 2:26. These things have I written unto you concerning them that seduce you. So there are people who seduce. So the first thing that will lead a man astray is people. They seduce. They lead you astray. This deception, you will see it in your conduct. That's where it begins. It will show in your conduct. It will show in your prayer. It will show in your praise worship. You know? It will show in your praise worship. This deception. It will show in your praise worship. When a church gathers and they are singing, hallelujah, angels are singing, hallelujah, angels, how will you be celebrating servants? An entire congregation of people celebrating their servants with lifting holy hands. That is a deceived audience in their song. They are led astray in their song. That's just one out of many. You know the others. Break every chain, break every chain. What? We are breaking with chain. How can you be breaking chain over born again believers? Which chain are we breaking? You are in Christ. Where are the chains? So in their song, there is plano. In their prayer, there is plano. In their conduct, you know, they put on a pious look, as if by their pious look they are righteous. So this deception by humans, by wrong teachers, by prophets, has a way of manifesting itself in conduct, in prayer, in praise worship, and in the way you relate with the so-called God that is a figment of your imagination. I'm teaching here. Please, if you're following, shout, I hear you. Yeah. Say, those that seduce you, be careful of those that seduce you, who teach wrong doctrine, who don't teach any doctrine at all. You know, there are churches that doctrine is not taught. The only thing taught there is motivation. Motivation is not doctrine. Are you here? Please wake up. If you are you with me, wake up so that I can feel you, so I can pour more things out. Are you here? There are motivational teaching is not doctrine. There's a difference between doctrine, and the people who deserve honor in the house of God are not motivational teachers. They are those who labor in word and doctrine. How to make it is a motivational teaching. 10 steps to success is a motivational teaching. How to make money is a motivational teaching. It's not sound doctrine. Sound doctrine is building believers in the revelation of Christ. That's sound doctrine. Teaching on ancestral causes is not doctrine. There's no such doctrine. So-called deliverance, making Christians vomit all the time, that's not doctrine. That is part of the plan we're dealing with here. That's part of the deception. It's error. Praise God. Are you understanding here? If you're understanding, shout, I hear you. Yeah? It's part of it. Part of plan, part of deception. Like comedians making caricature of spiritual things and Christians are laughing. It means that all those Christians have been misled. Somebody is leading them astray. Makes caricature, makes jokes of spiritual things. Take men of God and dismantle them in the name of comedy. Taking people that are supposed to be feeding your spirit man and reducing them to objects of clowning. And Christians are laughing because they have been led astray. They have been led astray. They have been led astray. That is why it doesn't matter to them anymore. Joke is joke. Joke is not joke. Amen.